gearing up for this Kansas City-Chicago matchup, Children's Mercy Park. Okay, you sit on the starting 11s for both sides. Again, Jill Lloyd and Maura Sheridan here on a very busy and very competitive NWSL weekend. Here's the starting 11 for Kansas City.
Balsager back into the starting lineup next to Elizabeth Ball. Delfavin Rodriguez will be ambitious to get forward to create those numerical advantages in the final third. Loetta will be in the single pivot. Exceptional passing range. Well, she'll look to use that to activate the wingers of Spancher and Cooper in those wide channels where Kansas City like to play make. Kristen Hamilton back into the starting lineup this week, and she'll look to feast on those surfaces inside the penalty area.
And this is the starting 11 for Chicago.
Casey Kruger out with an excused absence, which caused a cascade of changes. Chicago all chips in with this 3-4-3.
That Kansas City will play in this arena as they are building, of course, a new stadium for the current. Very exciting. Final game of the regular season is on the road. Now Cooper off her left foot, blocked by Aguilera. Nagasato through the middle. Light pass, Rodriguez intercepts, takes a shot, and it's off the crossbar.
Kansas City like to put so many numbers forward because of their possession. Counter press here through their outside backs. If Izzy Rodriguez gets a little window, decides to unleash herself from distance, and then
through the middle. He's got Ella Stevens as well on that left side. The rookie takes off, pokes it to Stevens. There's a shot, A.D. Franch denies. Getting the start today, as we mentioned, Kruger, Davidson, both out for the Red Stars. Congested there with Dabinia. She makes it work. Weaving through that Chicago defense. Nice pass ahead to Spanstra. Touches it out to Labonta. Service up. Off the rebound, Dabinia in the box, Rodriguez, gorgeous for Kansas City! Izzy Rodriguez!
Team goals, it starts with Dabinia here, just slaloming through traffic like Michaela Schifrin in between the lines, running at Kansas City's back line, plays it into Spantra, who intelligently plays it into Lo Labonta. Chicago can't clear their lines, and Izzy Rodriguez venturing forward from the outside back position keeps this one alive. Little combination play with Dabinia. Izzy Rodriguez in front of goal, 12 yards and in, just glides this one past Alyssa Nair, and what a team goal from the Kansas City Currents. Starts with Dabinia, she continues her run.
Bianchi goes for it, trying to go top shelf, and it sails over.
Boy, she takes those deep breaths.
They go with the short option. Cross in, deflected by Cooper, chaos, and it's in! Sharple scores! How about this start? Chicago gets the equalizer.
Ability to put pressure on Kansas City, not allow them to clear their lines. Third set piece in a row. Hawking gets around the edge, puts it into the mix. Kansas City can't clear their lines, and it just sat perfectly for Kayla Sharples in front of goal. It's a tap in, 6 yards and in, and that gives the Chicago Red Stars team life as she draws this one back level from the second phase of a corner kick. 1-1. Looked like that Kansas City eliminated Chicago on their last thread, but this is two teams that play really attractive, appealing brand of football, team goals.
Heel pass, Labonta swerves, shoots, scores! Lo Labonta! Well, that was flipping amazing.
Starts all the way in their defensive third from a throw-in. Loetto, using that exceptional long range of pass in that wide space, allows Kristen Hamilton to run onto it with green grass in front of her. Lo Labonta making that surging run out of the midfield, but great vision and awareness from Spantra to lay this off directly into the run of Lo Labonta. Perfect first touch, avoids pressure, puts it on her left foot in front, threatening goal, and it's an easy finish. Still had a lot of work to do from that touch. Just curls it around Alyssa Nair and gives Kansas City the lead. minutes after the Chicago equalizer.
Rodriguez on this corner. Outswinger. Ball! Almost volleys again.
Wide overlapping backs. And open-mindedness to just step in and give what you have to that role.
Spanstra leaves it for Gavinia. Tucks it in. Missed by Hamilton. Gave it her best shot.
And this is Loretta getting on the ball again with that pass in behind into the wide channels for Alexa Spanstra. Gets her head up, isolated against the outside back. Little deceptive, incisive pass into the run of Dabinia. Great awareness to play the...
Nagasato nearly muscled away by Spanstra. And it's a rookie who will get the call. Yellow card against Yuki Nagasato. Ball rising for it. Dabinia. It's a bad landing spot. Cooper ahead. Michelle Cooper fires. Yes! Think she was offside.
Tonight here, good pressure from Dabinia. Hamilton, Loetta in the mix as well. And just Cooper continues her run offside. It's a really good finish with the outside of her boots. Just a couple yards offside. Dabinia one touch too long. Chicago with a lifeline still in this first half. But it's that counter pressure from Kansas City.
Loetta has been really getting things going for Kansas City on the attack. Spanstra wide. In the box now, lose the defender, breaking some ankles. Alexa Spanstra, oh my goodness! The rookie can't be denied.
Who can set up others, but this time she converts herself. Izzy Rodriguez dishes her, she penetrates off the dribble, goes into a central pocket, uses the pace of the defender against him, takes that lateral touch, which gives her separation and a window to get this shot off, and nestles it into the side netting. But you have to love the confidence and the conviction to go on a one-woman dribbling expedition off the left-hand side.
2 minutes of stoppage time presented by Verizon. This one's gonna slip in! 80 French.
French. Ball gets played in behind the back line. It's played back through Balasagir. Routine ball here from 80 French. She tries to use the sole of her foot. She takes her eye off the ball for just a second. And just goes right underneath of her foot into the back. It takes her eye off it just for a second, and it's in the back of the net. But now's a really critical time. And this is a position that Hedy French has been in time and time again, where she has to step up. You have to put the mistake behind you. Your team needs you.
St. George, she's been hot as of late. Hockey, left foot strike blocked. Ball is down in some pain. We're still going. Bianchi! And that one off the crossbar, second chance too high.
Who finds Hawking at the top of the box. And that's where Elizabeth Ball gets stuck in. She goes down grabbing her ankle. That frees up some space for Bianchi from distance. Rings it off the crossbar.
Loretta up for Dabinia. Sprints to it. In the 18, Dabinia moves towards the middle, takes a shot, it's in, Dabinia!
And look at this finish, takes the lateral touch, it takes...
So they're gonna go look at this. Laura Rodriguez, our center referee.
Our assistant would say to have a look at this. It looks onside from here.
Yeah, and the flag went up initially. All right, looks like the check's complete. We'll see what the call is. It's going to count. Davinia scores. It's belated, but she tallies. Cook slides it forward. Malazzo with some speed in the area. Cross it back. Here's a chance for Bianchi, and it's saved on the line. Tapped home. On the second opportunity, St. George scores.
And the Red Stars attack through Ava Cook. Combination play in the wide area. Tremendous energy to get around the edge, but even better awareness to find Bianchi at the top of the box, who redirects this one on frame. Izzy Rodriguez can't clear it. St. George wise to it, putting herself in a really good position. Just feasts on this half chance and glides it past a diving AD France. Chicago has rolled their...
Kristen Hamilton will exit.
So much credit to Kristen Hamilton on that fourth goal for Kansas City. It might go unnoticed, that little movement, but she knows Davinia's there.
Ball. Physical play there from St. George. Reckless, too.
Frustration. A little bit of trying to get pressure on the ball, and it's a clumsy challenge there from St. George.
Blocked down by Kansas City. Cooper. Pass Nagasato. Tons of green. Chicago getting back. Rips a shot, it's high. It's gonna happen. I never say that word, by the way. Mayer hesitates. Larson, 1v1, cross in. Cooper, no. Alyssa Ayer, you can see very clearly saying, what are you checking? Because Chicago wants to go. They want to finish out this game. They're gonna review this. This is the second time.
They must be checking the contact between Bianchi and Cooper to deem if it was enough to initiate Cooper's movement down to the ground, or did she leave her feet on her own accord trying to push that ball past Nair?
Seven minutes roughly to go. Ends up with Cooper sprinting. Turns on the Jets for CeCe Kaiser. Kaiser takes a shot, it's in! CeCe Kaiser! Five goals for Kansas City!
Backing half, it's a giveaway here. Cooper wins it, progressive first touch forward, draws pressure to herself, sees CeCe Kaiser out of the corner of her eye, making that diagonal run from outside to inside. Brilliant ball right into the run of Kaiser, who takes an attacking touch forward, gets Alyssa Nair moving, tries to go for the kick save through the legs of Alyssa Nair, and CeCe Kaiser finds her name on the score sheet, puts this one to bed.
That will likely do it. Had turned the season around, but it was so late in the year, it's tough with all the good teams across the league. Larson wants another one, and it's in! Kansas City cannot stop scoring!
Kansas City Current just putting on a show from a set piece. Loetta puts it in behind. Mimi Larson runs onto it, opens up, shows where she's going to go, and just hits it with such placement, bends it around. Alyssa Nair, who gets caught just a touch too close to her near post. Influenced there by the run of CeCe Kaiser. That frees up a little bit of space for Larson.
For the Current. And if this is a taste of next year, you gotta be feeling pretty good. Kaiser wants in on the action. Slips through, CeCe Kaiser shoots, and it's just off.
The announcer can't even get his commentary in on who scored the last one before Kansas City's creating another opportunity.
Well, that's going to do it. Final whistle blows. Kansas City with an electric win at home.